ओके, एम आई ऑडिबल? हेलो, यस प्रीति, एम आई ऑडिबल? आई होप सो. Okay. Yes. So let us start with session. Yes. So welcome back to the GATE course based on power system. So this is AICT sponsored Prerna Center for SCST student at VPKBIT Baramati. Today we are learning the basic course for power system, and topic will be covered is performance of transmission line, distributed system and cable. This is session number 3. I am Professor Ramchandra Rakte, working as assistant professor in VPKBIT Baramati. Okay, so as such, we have seen performance of transmission line so far. We have started to solve some numerical. Let us first recap this numerical first, and then we'll move for the next topic. Yes. So first we'll start with the previous grade problem. That's why I have taken screenshot to avoid our time. So these are the gate problem which have been asked in previous gate exam paper based on power system. Okay, as you know, according to the syllabus of 2022 gate syllabus, there are 10 marks of weightage for this gate. Your course power system. Okay, yes. So based on that, I have picked some important topics, and I will try to cover. Yesterday I have covered 3 topics, and today I will cover 2 topics. So I hope it is almost 40 to 50% part I will cover this within this 2 session. Yes. So let us start with the problem what they have said. Yes. So first I will read out this. What they are saying: considering a long 2-wire line composed of solid round conductors, the radius of both conductor is 0.25 centimeter and the distance between their centers is 1 meter. If the distance is double, now this is the question that we have to find out the answer for it. If this distance is double, then the inductance per unit length will be what? This is what they have asked. Means what? If you just summarize the given data, what they are saying, it is a conductor of radius. Obviously, we will need a radius for the calculation of inductance. So its radius is 0.25. They have kept the distance apart from the center. So they are saying these are the 2 conductors. Okay, yes, this is 2-wire conductor. 2-wire means there are 2 conductors who are placed a distance of 1 meter from their centers. So most of the students get confused. They will write down as this one. This is a distance D. But please look into the matter what they have been given. They are saying the distance between the center. So this is the distance D. Correct? Now, yes, they have given. And now they have been asked, if the distance is double, then the inductance per unit length. Okay. So now let us move to the solution. What they have given. I will draw this circuit again here. So what they have given? This is 1 conductor. Okay, this is the distance. And this distance is given as 1 meter. This one is the radius. And the radius of both conductor is same, that is 0.25. Correct? Now they have been asked, if this distance is double. So now it is, in first case, it is D. Suppose this D is nothing but what? How much they have given? They have given 1 meter. So suppose this D is 1 meter, and they have been asked, what will the inductance? So first we have to calculate inductance for distance is equal to 1 meter, and again we have to calculate the inductance for when the distance between the conductor gate doubles. Okay, so as you know, we have the basic formula of inductance per conductor, per phase. Okay, and what is that? That is nothing but this one. Inductance per phase is given as 0.2 ln D upon R dash millihenry per kilometer, because we are taking this inductance per conductor, and we know in our transmission line, because what we are looking for, we are looking for the performance of transmission line in power system. Okay, so this inductance per conductor, so this is one phase, they have calculated this inductance per phase. Now they have been given as 0.2 ln D upon R dash millihenry per kilometer. Okay, yes. Now let us see what you mean by distance D. So here distance D, we know it is 1 meter. So we simply put 1 meter. Now this R dash, you know, as we have seen in previous classes, R dash is nothing but what? 0.778. Keep this in mind. It will save you not much time in your exam into R. So if you know this only radius R, you have to just multiply it with 0.788 and you will get R dash. Okay, so that's what we have done here. 0.7788 into 0.25. So where we got the 0.25? From here. They have already given radius R is equal to 0.25. And this is equal for both the conductor. Correct? So, and now this is 0.25. So what is this one? This is one is nothing but this is in centimeter. And as we look here, the unit, it is in meter. So definitely we have to convert into the meter. So it is 10 raised to minus 2. So let us see how we have put the value. It is inductance per phase. 0.2 ln. Distance is 1 meter. So as we have put the distance is 1 meter, here also we have to put in meter, so that a meter get cancelled and your unit will be millihenry per kilometer. So 0.7788 into 0.25 into 10 raised to minus 2. Now, I hope you are present with your calculator. Just put this value and check whether it is this one. So definitely you will get the values of inductance per phase as 1.248 millihenry per kilometer. Okay, so in some case they will ask only up to this one, correct, in your competitive examination. But now you are appearing for the gate, they have made some twisted. Why? What extra twisted? So they have saying, yes, you got this value of inductance at this location, at this particular location of when they are placing 1 meter apart. Now they are asking, when this distance D is equal to 2 meter, what will be the effect of inductance, whether it is increase or decrease? Okay, so that's why we have to calculate here also inductance for distance is equal to 2 meter. So what will the change? Only this distance will gonna change. Rest of the things will remain same. 0.2 ln, 0.788, 0.25 into 10 raised to minus 2, 0.788, here R, this is centimeter to meter conversion, or rest of the things will remain same. Again, we will put this value and we will get inductance per phase as 1.38 millihenry per kilometer. Okay, so I give you 1 minute, just put this value in your calculator and just check whether it is correct or not. So that we will conclude from this equation, we will conclude what is the inductance. Okay, I hope you obtain this both the equations, both values for inductance per phase for a distance is equal to 1 meter and the inductance per phase for a distance is equal to 1 point, distance equal to 2 meter. So what the value we have obtained, that is 1.2, let us write down here, inductance is obtained is 1.248. I'll write down only 2 digit, and here inductance is obtained is 1.38. Now let us move to the our numerical, what they have been asked. So what they have been asked, if the distance is double, then the inductance per unit length, if the distance is double. Okay, so we have to find out the value for both the situation. Inductance is equal, your distance is 1 meter, and distance when we will double it. So then the inductance will be what? Whether it is double, let us check. So this is 1.24 and this is 1.38. So obviously, if you just multiply, if you want it double, so this should be somewhat related, 2 point something. But this is 1.38. So obviously, it is not double. Whether it is half? No, it is also not half. It is not also half. Now, third option is increases but not double. Let us check. Yes. Now, second inductance has been increases. As we know, this is 1.24 and this is 1.38. Yes, it has been increases by some percentage, but it is not double. So, this third option is correct. Correct? Yes. So, now just see. For just to know, this is somewhat a analyzing data. This question is based on analysis purpose, but for this, we have to calculate these two equations. Apparently, two equations cut over again. So first, we have find out the inductance when distance is equal to 1 meter. And second one, the distance is equal to 2 meter. And from the values that we have obtained, we will have able to analyze that the distance, if you increase the distance, then inductance per unit length increases, but not double. Okay, so such type of example they have been asked. Now this is the one previous gate example. Okay, yes, I hope you understood this one. Okay, now let us move further. This is another example. I will read out for you. The horizontally spaced conductor of single phase line operating 50 hertz, okay, are having outside diameter of 1.6 centimeters. So they have given diameter. We will list out what they have given while reading itself. Spacing between the centers of conductor, please keep in mind, centers of conductor is 6 meter. So this is the centers, and the distance D they have given. So distance D is nothing but, they have given 6 meter. And the first one was the diameter. The diameter was 1.6. Of course, it is centimeter. The permittivity of free space, okay, this is the given data, we already know it. Free space is 8.854 into 10 raised to minus 12 farad per meter. Okay. Now they have been asked the capacitance to ground per kilometer of each line. Okay. So yesterday in last session we have seen the capacitance calculation formula. So what is the formula? The formula is C is equal to phase, this is A phase, and the neutral is given as phase and the neutral. So I'll write down here phase, and this is neutral, is given as 2 pi epsilon 0 epsilon r upon ln your natural log into d upon r. So now don't confuse between this capital D and small d. Most of the students make this kind of mistake in while solving the example. Since this d is nothing but the distance between the conductor, please keep in mind, I will make this difference right now here itself. Small d represents the distance. Capital D represents the diameter of the conductor. And if you know, in any mathematical calculation, they never ask for the diameter. Or you can say, in any formula, we cannot put diameter directly. What we have to do? We have to obtain radius. So we will simply divide it by 2 and we will put the value of radius in the equation. Okay. You cannot find any finding for directly for diameter. Okay. So they have been always, the D is nothing but your distance. Now this distance will be between the, either between the conductor or between the centers of the conductor. Okay. Depends. So this is the distance between the conductor. Okay. Yes. Let us see what they have given. Also, we never required 50 hertz. So we never require the frequency calculation, frequency data for calculation of RLC. What we are calculating, we are checking the performance of transmission line. Okay. So in that performance, we have seen different factors along with resistance, inductance, capacitance, inductive reactance, and capacitive reactance. Correct? Yes. So let us put this value in the equation. So we will get the final value as, so let us go one by one. 2, we know the value of pi, we know the value of epsilon, we know the value of epsilon r. Now ln is nothing but your d by r. So here d is what they have given, center of the conductor. So d is nothing but 6 meter. What is the value of r? So r, instead of r, they have given the diameter. Yes, so they have given the diameter. So we'll simply divide it by 2 and we will get r as a 0.8 centimeter. But if you remember, it's a 0.8 centimeter and the distance is given in meter. So definitely either you have to convert meter to centimeter, centimeter to meter, to cancel out each units. So we will simply convert centimeter into the meter. So we will write it as 0.8 into 10 raised to minus 2. Okay. So if you just now, yes. So this is what equation we have put it, all the data in this equation. Okay. Now you have your calculator with you. Just solve it and let us check the value will be up to this or not. Okay, you have 2 minutes. Simply put the all values of capacitor equation and let us check whether we have obtained the same values or not. Yes, I hope you have found out same value or somewhat near value for the capacitance. Don't forget to put the units as farad per kilometer. If you remember in last session, we have find out the inductance. So that's why it is a Henry per kilometer. And here it will be farad per kilometer. Okay. Yes. So just we have seen some example based on line parameter, or we have seen the example on parameter of your performance of your line or your transmission line. Okay. So let us say one more example. and this is for your homework. So what they have given? A single phase transmission line, okay, of two conductor, each of 10 mm radius. Means what they have given? A single phase transmission line, okay. Single phase transmission line is there and it is of two conductor. So we'll say it is a two conductor. Okay. Each of radius 10 mm. So each of radius, so this R is they have given, that is 10 mm. 10 mm. These are fixed at the center to center distance. Means they have given the distance between the center. So every time you have to read it very carefully for the distance and radius. Most of the, in hurry, most of the student get put it incorrect value. They get confused between the diameter and the distance. Okay. Now they are saying they are in horizontal plane. Okay. We have drawn the equation in horizontal plane itself. Now, let us move further. What they have given? This is now converted to three-phase transmission line. Okay. So, in previous example, we have looked for single phase two wire system. Here also we have looked for the inductance. Here we have looked for capacitance, but the system was the same, single phase. Now we are looking, we'll move into three phase system. Okay, and you know, when we look for the three phase system, okay, I will just recap you what is the difference between single phase and three phase. Yes, so what we are using, we are using the bundle conductor, and this is, you know, yesterday in last session we have seen these two conductor per phase, that is representation is like this one. Now this is a three phase, and if it is three phase four wire, we will represent in this way. Okay, so accordingly your distance is going to change. Okay, so for three conductor per phase, you will have the cubic root. If you move for the fourth one, you will have 1.09 into 1/4 root. So this is going to increase. If you move for the five conductor, now this is not actually in place, but yes, it is there if you go for the double line. So here three phase lines are passing. Here also three phase lines are passing. Then there may be chances of six conductor per phase. So this goes on increasing, and we will also have a look for this bundle conductor, or we can say performance. This is chart is nothing, but this is very much important. I always say you have to keep this screenshot of it. This is much, very much important as per your competitive exam. This represents performance of transmission line. Okay, where we have identified a length, a distance, a radius, symmetrical spacing, unsymmetrical spacing, effect of earth and height of the conductor. And if these parameter are related with my resistance, with my inductance, with my inductive reactance, capacitance, and the capacitive reactance, what will the effect of this each parameter on my performance, on my transmission line? So overall, these represent the performance of line parameter. Okay. Yes. So this part we have seen. Okay. Now let us move to the our example. What they have given? They are saying, now we have converted to the three phase transmission line. By how we have converted? By introducing third conductor of same radius. Okay, so just now we have seen, if you move from the, say, two conductor to the three conductor, how we are going to represent? Now this was the previous one, both the twos are there, and we will just simply add one, so that will represent. Okay, so this is somewhat related to this one. Okay, same way we will do the changes in our numerical example. We'll simply add one more conductor, and they are saying this is of same radius, so it doesn't matter. So this R will be again 10 mm. Why? How we can say this is 10 mm? Because they have already given here two conductor of each radius 110 mm. Okay, Now this conductor is fixed at an equal distance d from two single phase conductor. Equal distance, suppose this is distance 1 meter. Now they are not saying that this distance is equal to 1 meter. No, what they are saying, this third conductor is placed equidistant from these two conductor, means this distance and this distance will be the same, but they are not given, they are not saying that this distance is 1 meter. They are not saying this distance is 1 meter. They are saying this distance are equidistant from this both conductor. So if it is 2 meter, so definitely this one also 2 meter. It might be also 1 meter. This is 1 meter. It might be 3 meter also. This will be 3 meter. Means the third conductor is placed in a such a way that both it is at a equidistant from this both conductor. Okay, this they have given. Okay, let us move further. Now they are saying the three phase line is fully transposed. Okay, so this is known as transpose. So you know the what you mean by transpose. Okay, so yeah, I think you go on over this transpose of the system. Okay, or if you are third year student, you might come across this in your power system too. Okay, yes. So the positive sequence inductance per phase of three phase system is 5% more than that of inductor per phase in single phase system. Okay, so they are saying three phase inductance and single phase inductance are having more by 5%. Okay, so there is a difference of 5%. If you just convert it into the percentile, it will come at 0.05. Okay, and now they are saying more than, they are not saying it is 5% off, they are saying more, means first 100% is there and in they are saying 5% more. This is what they are doing. So that's why I'm taking too much concept, focusing on this example, because if you know this example, if you just understood this example, all the problems are you are able to solve. Okay, they are saying 5% more. So if it is 100% and one more 5%, so it is given as 105%. Okay, and if you simply put in our values, we will say it is 1.05%, not percent, 1.05. Okay, yes. Now let us see what they are asking. Definitely they have not given the distance, so definitely they will ask for the distance, no doubt. Okay, let us see what they are saying. Yes, the distance d in the meter is correct, because all the value they have given, they have given the inductance, they have given, okay, they have not given the inductance, but with this 5% they have given that if we can equalize the inductance. So how we can equalize? Let us see further. Okay, let us solve the solution. Let us move to the solution. Okay, what they are saying, okay, yeah, if you just compare this one, we have gone in same way. Okay, only that they have represented this at the downside, no doubt. This is just a representation. In fact, the culture side, no doubt. This is just a representation. Okay, what they are saying? These are the two equidistance of same radius. So R is 10 meter. Third inductor is get added. Third conductor is get added, not inductor. Inductance is related to the particular conductor. Third conductor is get added. Yes. Now what they are saying? What they are saying? It is 5% more. It is 5% more of single phase. Single phase peksha 5% just ahe. So three phase system is 1.5% more than single phase system. So this is what the equation we can write from given data. Okay. Now we don't know the value of inductance. Okay, so we cannot put the value of inductance here. Yes, but we know the formula for inductance. Correct? We know the formula for inductance. What it is? 0.2 ln d upon r dash. Correct? Make clear this is r dash, not r. Okay, I'll check this color. Make sure this is r dash. Okay, In hurry, you can just put it R. No, that is wrong. Okay. Yes. So this 1.05 is there. Now we will just put the value of single phase inductance per phase, and this is for three phase. So you know, for three phase we have the cubic root. Okay. So we will just put the values. As we know, this might get cancelled. This might get cancelled. So 1000 upon, now where will this 1000 come from? As you know, the distance is what they have given. It is a 1 meter. Okay. So we have put it, and the radius is in 10 mm. As in from previous, I am saying you have to make this unit equalization. Either you go from meter to centimeter or centimeter to meter. So here the radius is in mm. So simply I have make this as 1 meter is nothing but 1000 mm. Okay, is that clear? Yes. So we'll simply just put this value, and you will find out the value for distance d. That's a simple. But if you just look over the example, it is too much big. Okay, so here the gate examination checks your knowledge of thinking or depth of thinking for this particular example. Okay, equation is very simple. You don't have to do too much in it. Just you have to put the values and you have to calculate. Okay, if you know the simple, so that's why I'm saying, if you know the basic formula, forget about the derivation part. If you know the basic formula, okay, so after this session, it's your responsibility. Whatever the formula we have solved this numerical, what the formula we have seen, you have to just list it out on some one paper, one page paper, paste it on your front side or your desk, and just have a look over it. You will definitely able to solve one or two example based on this question. I bet it. Okay, because question might be directly asked, but some kind of twisted, like this one. Here they have not given that you have to directly put the value and you have to do calculation. Okay, here also they have not given you have to put the value and do the calculation. But if you know the formula, definitely you are able to find out the answer. Correct. This is the basic. This is the level of gate exam. Okay. Yes. So I hope you are able to find out. Now this is the calculation part. You have to do it on your calculator. This is not a manual calculation. Definitely you need a calculator. And your gate exam, you will have a virtual calculator. Okay. Your handy calculator is not allowed. You have the virtual calculator on your screen. Okay. So try to solve the gate examination on this virtual calculator. Okay. There are much more dummy question papers are available. You can try to solve this and have a practice. Practice makes man perfect. This is a proverb from our last Asian time. You have to think on it. Okay. Yes. Now this is okay. We will take one more example, because this is now a theoretical part we have started. Theoretical gate questions we have started, and this is for your study. Okay, here this is for your homework, we can see. Okay, so first I will read out first question, and then after you can take a screenshot and you can have a yes. So what is the first question? This is also part of previous gate question. Yes, such type of question also asks. Okay, what they are saying, the insulation level of 400 kV EHV overhead transmission line is dated on the basis of. Okay, if you are saying EHV, it's overhead and it's a 400 kV. Of course, it is a extra high voltage line. It get dated basis of lighting over voltage, switching over voltage, corona inception voltage, radio and TV intervals. So out of this option, fourth one is absolutely not, because when we are dealing with the extra high voltage line, definitely this interference is not the case for the insulation failure. Okay. Yes, it caused the quality power quality significance, but it not caused the insulation failure. Okay. Yesterday we have seen the cause of interference. Okay. In corona loss, in cause of interference when you move for the higher voltage rating. Yes, but it not cause the insulation level. Yes. So what they are saying in okay, In transmission line, lighting overvoltage are more severe compared to the switching overvoltage, definitely. So the lighting voltage are external voltages, hence the insulation is provided for switching voltage. Yes. So what is the meaning of it? The insulation level of 400 kV overhead transmission line is on the basis of switching overvoltage. Why? Because lighting overvoltage is some type of sudden discharge on the transmission line. But when we want to have the concentration of this insulation means, suppose this is the one conductor of, suppose this is a cable of length 300 square mm, or we can say IHT cable, because this is EHV, I'll say this is 1000 square mm. Now you know, in previous class we have seen what is mean by this square mm, how it comes. Okay, so this is the conductor inside, outer side is nothing but your insulation. If you are operating this cable or the for some kind of use, so there might be chances of switching overvoltage. Due to the switching overvoltage, there might be chances of insulation failure. And we are using for overhead transmission line, so there is no such type of insulation. It is a bare conductor, but around this conductor, there is a dielectric. Which kind of dielectric? It is air. Okay, so this kind of insulation might be get break. Okay, yes. So the what we have seen some basic example, not basic, a depth example. In last session we have seen the basic example. Today we have seen some depth example of performance of line parameter. Here we have seen the inductance, capacitance, transposed line, single phase distribution of conductor, three phase distribution of conductor. Okay, now we can take screenshot of this one for your homework. This is for your homework. These are the theoretical one, that's why I'm giving it for your homework. You can take a screenshot of it so that we will move further for next topic. You can take a screenshot of this one also. Simply you have to put the values in the equation, that's it. But for that you will able to know what's the that particular equation is for. This is also for your homework. This one is also for your homework. Yes. So let us start with the next session. Next topic, that is your distribution system. Okay. So far we have started with performance of transmission line. Now let us start with the next topic, that is distribution system, and then we look for the cable. Cable part is somewhat related to the power system for the gate perspective, but most of the part is they have been asked in your exam, that is about distributed system. Okay. So let us start. Yes. So what we are going to look for in underground system, we look for the classification of cable. Okay. Likewise, what we have seen, a transmission line is nothing but what? It was an overhead system. Overhead transmission line or overhead system. Now we look for the underground system. So underground system is nothing but we are looking for the cable. And when it is overhead transmission line, we will call it as a conductor. Okay. This is the basic difference between this system. When you move for the overhead transmission line, we will call it that conductor. Overhead transmission line, you cannot say it is a cable. Okay, it's a conductor, it's a bare conductor whose insulation is nothing but its air. But in underground cable, we have put it out some insulation, and that is called as cable. Okay, so and that measured in square mm, length of the size of the cable, not length, length measured in kilometer, size of the cable is measured in square mm. Okay, and last session we have seen how to measure this square mm, how this unit comes as a square mm. Okay, so in this session we look for the underground cables and then we look for the distribution system. Because if you're not aware about the underground cable, now this is not the basic part, we will go in depth because we are looking for gate examination. So we will go in depth of underground system. Okay, so this part is not important as advantage, disadvantage. Yes, this is the start of our underground cable. But for intro, we will start with the advantage and disadvantage. I'll say this instead of advantage, I'll say it's a features of this underground cable. Okay, then we look for the classification of cables, construction of cable, then its stress distribution. This is one more point. Then to avoid this, we will look for the grading of cable for three core cable. And then finally, we will look for the previous gate question. Okay, so let us begin with this underground system. And the topic is nothing but your cable. And after that, we will look for the distribution system. When we come to know how these cables are or the role of cable, then we look for the distribution system, voltage drop, substation, and then we'll solve some numerical based on previous gate question. And at the final, you will have some kind of homework. Okay, let us start. Yes,
just within 2 minutes, I will recap these underground cables and then we'll start with the features. Then we start with the actual features of the cable. Yes. So what do you mean by, if someone asks you what is cable?
What is my cable? So definitely what cable consists of, suppose this is my conductor. This is my conductor. Which material it is made up of? Yesterday we have seen it is made up of copper, it is made of aluminium, it is made of gold, it is made of bronze, iron, whatever it is. But mostly we are using a conductor of copper and aluminium because of its certain advantages and certain importance. Not either, always there is advantage, there are certain importance, and that's why we are looking for copper and aluminium. Now these inductors, when it is surrounded by certain insulation layer on it, so that is nothing but formation of cable. And this is the basic difference between your conductor and insulator. So in overhead transmission line, we have mostly deal with the conductor. Now we are dealing with the cable. Okay, so simply we have, for your sake of understanding, we can say simply we have added one extra layer on that particular conductor and we will call it as cable. That's it. Okay, so what they are saying, it is a combination of conductor and its insulator, and its insulator that is called as a cable. That's it. So this is nothing but cable it stands for. Okay, so which material? Yes, now this cable, copper conductor is extensively used for the cable. As we know, in overhead cable, instead of copper, we are using aluminium. Okay, this is the role of aluminium material and copper material for use in underground cable and overhead line. Okay, so for overhead line, we have most of the time we have used aluminium because of its certain features and in overhead system. And for underground, instead of aluminium, we look for, mostly we look for cable. So basic example, in your domestic also, if you find there is some wires or cable, so insulation is put it over here of black wire. If it is red, so it is a red wire insulation. It is yellow, then yellow wire insulation. So these are the color code they have been given in our electrical system. So whatever the conductor inside it, it is made up of copper material. Okay, and you are most are aware about it, that the material being used in our domestic, or we can say a handy use for domestic, commercial, industrial, it is of underground cable. It is of copper material. Okay, and same material, now you know we are moving our power system scenario is changing their look and feel of your electrical system, and we are moving from overhead to underground. Okay, and that's why most of the work you can see is your surrounding. There are most of the work are underground work is going on, and we are looking for
this part of this underground cable. Okay,
so 2.2 we consider. What do you mean by cable? What is the difference between the cable and conductor? Okay, so mostly aluminium are related with the conductor. I am using word mostly. Okay, you can use copper also here. In cable, you are mostly using copper, but you can use aluminium also. Okay, that's the case. Okay, now all these electrical cables are consist of mainly three features. So let us see which are they. So the first one, they are saying the conductor of transmitting electrical power. Definitely, this cable is used for transmitting electrical power. That is the most and important features of this cable. The insulation and the electrical insulating medium needed to insulate the conductor from direct contact with the earth or other object. Definitely, this insulation plays an important role if you are using it for underground. So there are maybe chances for the direct contact to the earth. And if it happens, there are lot much hazardous to our system. That's why your insulation plays an important role here. Also, external protection system protects from the mechanical damage. Now you just take an example, if bare conductor is there and we are using it for underground system, and for underground system, if you look for, there are much more parallel operation are going on. Means what? If you just look at the roadside, suppose this is the one kind of roadside, you can observe here, such kind of parallels are there. They are denoted as, this is HV, this is gas pipes. So they have given their names. So what they are showing, this is LT cable. Yashe tumhala rastacha rodlay peksha dekal disti. Okay, so what they are saying, we have installed, we have laid some our cable. So this shows we have laid our LT cable throughout this length. We have laid high voltage cable, we have used AC cable, we have used communication cable. So this kind of decals you can see around the roadside. Okay, so with some mistake or manual error, you are in parallel or in accordance with this, so there are maybe chances of mechanical damage. Okay, suppose one person is digging over here, he is laying his cable, but he don't know at the same location a HV line cable is there, AC line cable is there, and if he is digging this particular or laying that particular cable, there are more chances to breaking or make damage of this cable. Correct. So such type of scenario happens in underground cable. So to protect this, we also need an insulation key. Okay, so this is the basic role of insulation. First one, a conductor which transmits the electrical power, it is surrounded by some insulation to avoid direct contact with the earth. And third one is for protect it from mechanical damage. Okay, apart from mechanical damage, there are also factors, that is electrochemical attack, chemical scenario is there, fire is there. Likewise, we have discussed, fire cable is they have laid, any other communication cable is they have laid. So all this comes under the category of external factors to the cable. Okay, so these are shows us that underground cable is necessary to avoid external factors which will protect your cable, which will harm to your cable. And with the help of insulation, you will able to cover all these scenario. Okay, so that is why the insulation is more important. Okay, let us move further. Yes, now here they have seen,
you can take a screenshot also, or no doubt I will provide this all material to you.
They are saying main requirement of insulating material in cable. Why there is need? So main important is it provide high insulation resistance, it provide high dielectric strength, and definitely mechanical property. Now we have seen each case one by one, what is the role of it. But now the question arises, sir, you have says the conductor is there. Okay, here says the insulation material is there. But now the question is it possible to use any kind of material as an insulation? As we have said, there are copper is there as a conductor. We can use aluminium as a conductor. We can use gold as a conductor. We can use bronze as a conductor. We can use iron as a conductor. So these are some materials in which we can have the conductor. Correct? But for insulation, is it the things we can use any kind of material? No. For insulation also, they have certain kind of insulation. That is, we can use vulcanized rubber. This is the first one, vulcanized rubber. We can use butyl rubber. We can use silicon rubber. We can use neoprene rubber. We can use polyvinyl. We can use impregnated paper. So any type of material can be used for our insulation. Okay, clear. So for your convenience, you can just make a difference of insulating material, and here you can make conductive material being used. So you can just make it like this one. Copper is there, aluminium is there, and so on. Gold is there, then bronze is there, iron is there. So this is a quick review. Okay, during this session, kindly take some short notes, prepare for some short notes, because after this session, there are many chances you might be forget all these things, key things. So this is best for your practice. So insulation material are this one. So which kind of insulation? Cable insulation. Such kind of insulation. Okay. And this is the conductor. I'll say this is the conductor. Okay. Let us move further. So let us see advantage and disadvantage. So definitely when we are saying advantage, definitely we will compare our underground system with overhead system. Because it is a rule, universal rule. When you have to be more fruitful for something, you have to compare it. Okay, so we'll simply compare our underground cable with the overhead lines. So that let us see which are the different factors for this underground cable, which make this more efficient than overhead line. So what they are saying, it is densely populated circuit where overhead lines are not possible. Yes. When we are moving for the urban city or multiple city, so they are definitely installing a cable or installing certain tower in the crowded area, populated area, and to disturb its beauty, we will definitely say it is a quite not that much feasible for that look of that particular system. So definitely for densely populated, this is one concern. Another concern is what? Where we cannot utilize that particular things or installation of this tower in full-fledged manner. In that case also, overhead lines are having certain types of limitation. That's why we are moving for underground system. Next thing, underground cables provides better regulation. Yes, this is the most important thing. Definitely we will have better regulation, voltage regulation in underground system. Third one and most important, the chances of accident in underground system are very low compared to overhead lines. So such kind of accident is nothing but external factors. Okay, so you must have seen the conductor is break due to some things. If there is a windy condition, if there is a rainy season, or any external factors who is colliding over our circuitry. So these are nothing but a drawback of overhead system. Okay, and as the cable we are laying down on the ground for with better insulation, the chances of failure or fault are less compared to overhead line. Okay, you mark this, you can just take a screenshot. These are the most important. I have not put out any randomly thing. These are the most important features, or we can say advantage of your underground transmission line. Okay, clear. So first is for the populated city, and this is the most thing that we are moving. Now we are moving for underground system. In urban city, you can observe there are a lot much work are going for the underground construction. Okay, then we get the better regulation. Then next chance is less chances of accidents, and most important is causes of failure and fault. If you just think on it, In overhead transmission line, there are much more chances of short circuiting. If there is a windy condition or there is high wind is going on in the rainy season, there are more chances of short circuiting. Okay, but this is not case in underground cable. Yes, we cannot say it's ideal condition. Okay, we cannot say it's ideal condition because after some interval time, underground cable is also having some effect. Okay, it also shows some defect. There are also some drawbacks, but compared to overhead lines, it is good one, we can say. Okay, and that's why it is comes under the category of advantages. Okay. Yes, as we are saying, it has some defects. So let us see what the demerit. Underground cables are very costly, definitely, because overhead we are using aluminium material. First thing, in overhead we are using aluminium material, and in underground we are using which material? Which material?
Copper.
Copper. So definitely, if you just compare the cost of if you just compare the cost of these two material, you will come to know in terms of economy. Okay, so I'll say this is my conductor and I'll say this is my cable. Okay, here I'm using aluminium and here I'm using copper. So definitely one cost factor is there. Here these are the bare conductor. So the cost of insulation get cancelled. Here we are putting extra insulation. Okay, now this insulation part is another thing. You cannot assume this is one layer insulation. If you just go in inside of the cable classifications, you will come to know there are 7 layers of this cable. How many? 7 layers. So such type of insulation, and each layer has its important. Okay. So around this cable, your conductor, there are 7 layers of insulation. So definitely it will increase its cost compared to overhead transmission line. Now next is practically identification of. Just let me change this color. Practically, identification of cable fault is difficult than in cable fault in overhead transmission line. Okay, I'll give the practical example. In overhead transmission line, between this one tower to another tower, if you just compare the two significant parameters, you will come to know, yes, at this location, we have got the fault. And overall this, now this is the distance between towers, suppose is of 5 km or 10 km. Within this region, you have certain range. But same thing, if this is my feeder pillar, this is another feeder pillar, and this is the cable which is underground. So suppose this is my ground level. This is my underground cable. And if I found some breakage at this particular location, whether I will, yes, I'll come to know at this particular things I have some breakage, but I cannot visualize, I cannot find out easily compared to overhead transmission line. So for that, we need to use one instrument of fault cable detector for the underground system. Okay, so such kind of instrument we need to add, correct? That is one more concern. Next thing, jointing of cable is difficult, hence tapping for loads and service mains is not convenient. Now what is meant by joint? Suppose this is a cable breakage. Okay, this one is a cable breakage. Compared to the aluminium, we have just have some kind of joint value and we can just rejoin them and system will come back in operation. But in cable, we need again one methodology, that is heat shrink. Now this is what I'm telling you is just the practical example. I have worked on this. Heat shrink concept is there, where we are utilizing one another kit for this joining. But as you know, these are done through manually. These are done manually. And when we are saying manually, there is a presence of what? When we done things manually, there is a presence of human error. And because of this human error, after some time interval, you might get another difficulty. Okay, so these are the drawbacks. But you know, each things on living on the earth has some merits and demerits. But looking towards this advantage, definitely we look for this underground system. And most of this developed or densely populated or development city, urban city, metropolitan city, now we are moving for the underground system. Okay, so these are the advantage and disadvantage. Now let us start with our actual session of how, and we can say how we can identify this is which type of cable. Okay, which type of cable. So definitely when it comes to the cable, we call it as tension. Now this tension is not the term related with the human psychology. This tension is nothing but the tightness bonding between that particular conductor cables. Okay, so let us start with this. According to the number of conductor, you know, it is a, we can have single conductor, two conductor, three conductor, and four core cable. Okay, now you should be fully focusing on underground cable. Okay, here if I use the term conductor, this is not overhead conductor. I'm talking about the copper conductor. Clear? Now what they are saying, if it is a single core, so that's why they are using word core. Okay, single core, two core, three core, and four core. Suppose I'll let you the example of this one. Okay, this is my insulation. I'm asking one question to you. Let me answer for this. This is my insulation. The outer circle is my insulation. Inside that, I'm having. Yes, so now this is how much, how many core cable this one?
Two core cable.
Yes, very good. This one?
Three core cable.
And this one?
Four core cable.
Can you identify some difference between these three and this one?
Yes, sir. Diameter is different.
Yes. Now, this is my error mistake, human mistake. This one, two, and three are of same diameter. And this is of some small case. So can you be able to identify what is, why it is? This is three phase. How many wire? Sorry, how many core?
Four core.
Four core cable. So now you have to modify yourself that in when we are looking for the cable, we will say it is a three phase and core. We have to deal in terms of core, and when we are moving for the overhead, we will say three phase, three wire, three phase, four wire, because it's a conductor. This is the basic thing we will come to know by the practical thing. I have worked on this, all these cables and overhead and underground transmission line. That's why I'm able to tell you what is the significant difference. Now, the question is what, why it is so small? Because it's a, which one? It's a which
neutral.
Cable? Neutral. This will act as a neutral. Okay. And this will act as my one phase. I'll say it is a R. I'll say this is Y. I'll say this is B phase. Okay. So this is also in our practical term, when I will go to purchase, I'll say it is a 3.5 core. Why? Because the cross-sectional area of the neutral is half of this one core. Okay, so somewhat time, if you go for, when you go in the industry and you start the working, you will come across this cable specification. There is one chapter, not chapter, there is one catalog, a cable specification. Then you come across, instead of four, you can come across 3.5 core. But in as per your curriculum, you can see it is a four core. Okay, because there is a, always there is a significant difference between the theoretical and practical knowledge. But in some case, your core section is equal to this phase. In some cases, when it is a high value of rating, then definitely we'll look for this four core. But mostly we'll look for 3.5 core. Okay, so this is just added knowledge for your convenience. This is not in your syllabus, no doubt. Yes. So let us start with the second topic, that not topic, second part, that is according to the voltage. This is what we are looking for. We are looking for the classification of cable. Okay. And keep this in mind. Don't think this is the theoretical one. I am teaching you on the basis of practical approach. Okay. So this is a technical parameter. So first, we have classified on the basis of number of conductor. And when it is related to the cable, we will call it as core. So we have the single core, we have the two core, we have the three core, and we have the four core cable. Okay. We have the such type of number of cables. Now, according to the voltage, definitely we will look for, how much amount of voltage rating it cable can be handled. So it is deal with the terms of tension. So this is somewhat different from your human psychology. That tension is different. Okay. So we are having low tension, high tension, super tension, extra high tension, and extra super voltage. Okay. In our human psychology, there is no such type of tension. Thoda tension, ajun thoda tension, asa kai nasta. Tension a tension is asta. But in our cable scenario, we are having get the category of tension. Okay. So let us, you can, okay, I'll this clear it for you. You can have a screenshot because this is much more important for your all competitive examination. Okay. You can take screenshot. Then I will start work on it. Or you can just note down. Okay, I hope so you have done it. Yes. So low tension cable is of range 1000 volt, or you can say it's the 1 kV. Okay, when we compare the high tension, it comes under the 11 kV. Why I'm showing in this way? Because rest of the things are in kV. Okay, so that's why I'm showing in this way. Super tension cable, because this is our how I work in industry. I have come across the word 1000 volt. I always say 1 kV, 11 kV, 33 kV, 66 kV, and 132 kV. Okay. So when it is low tension cable, you can say, yes, sir, it is a cable which can handle a voltage up to 1000 kV or 1 kilovolt. After that, what will happen? If I give the pressure or the voltage rating is of, I will use this cable who is operating on 22 kV, so definitely it will get damaged, because in cable there are more chances of short circuiting. Why short circuiting? Because if you just remember, this is my insulation, and inside this I am having 3 core, or I am having 4 core. So there be, if I increase the tension in this cable, there might be short circuiting, because this insulation are just a significant way to break. Here the breaks are, so there are might be chances of short circuiting. But this was the not the case in transmission line, overhead transmission line. Asa kay hota ka ithe? Yes, because in these two conductor there is sufficient difference, or not difference, sufficient distance. So they're not easy way of getting short circuited. Because of certain external factors, definitely there is a chance of fault. So that's why we'll call it a single phase fault, two phase fault. A fault tumhala maithi, correct? Line to ground fault, LG, then LLG, line to line ground fault. But in this cable, if we increase just as pressure, or if, because of some mechanical damage, definitely you will come across damage to the cable or short circuit to the cable. So that's why we will, on the basis of this classification, we are able to understand, or we are able to apply the practical way where I can install such type of cable. Okay, so for this low tension cable, I will use,
if that cable is handling capacity of 1 kilovolt, if I'm using for this cable for 400 volt, or suppose 3 phase AC supply
less than 1 kilovolt, then definitely this cable is suitable. Okay, so from this classification, what you will come to know, we'll come to know for which application which cable is suitable. That's it. And in industry, in a practical scenario, there is one term, cable classification or cable schedule, where we use this term. Okay, so for high tension cable, we can use it up to 11 kV. For super tension, we will use up to 22 or 33. For extra high tension, we will use up to 33 to 66. Listen here, it is 2. Okay, so whether it is for 33 kV application, and for 60C we will use extra high tension cable. For extra super, it will beyond 132. Okay, so this is the classification of the cable. Now let us see nature of application of insulation and its leadership. Okay, now at this instant you are not able to understood this concept because it is not that much necessary as per the gate point of view, but I have added it is considering the practical approach. So in practical we have used the term as per the application of insulation. We use definitely we'll always go for the belted H type cable, SL type and SCL. Okay, so this is not your in gate syllabus, or we can see this is not a practical theoretical approach. This is not a needy, but just for convenience I have added it. Okay, so these are the classification of cable. Now one more thing is remaining, that is according to the method of improving dielectric stress. Definitely dielectric stress is much more important in cable. So for this we will use solid type up to 33 kV. If it is useful for 500 kV we will use oil dielectric, liquid dielectric, and if it is for 235 kV up to 235 we'll use air as a dielectric or gas pressure as a dielectric. Okay, so what is the role of dielectric you will come to know later. And the types of cable is, that is a single core or two core. Now you know the basic difference between core, what core stands for. Okay, yes. Okay, yes. So let's have 2 minutes back. I'm posting one link in your chat box. You have to just fill this link. This is a feedback form, or you can say attendance of your. Just go through this link and we will resume our session within 2 minutes. And once done, drop your message in chat box. Yes, I hope that is sufficient for 2 minutes break. Okay. Let us start with where we left. Yes. So that was S. Am I audible? Yes, I hope I'm audible to all of you. Yeah. Yes, so where we left, we have covered basic classification based on conductor. So we have seen the number of conductors, single phase, okay, not single phase, single core, two core, three core, four core. Okay, so when we are dealing with the cable, definitely we are related with the core of a particular cable. Then we have seen the classification based on its voltage capacity. So we are saying it is a tension. Low tension is for 1 kV. High tension is for 11 kV. Then for 22, super tension. Extra high tension, 33 to 66. And extra super voltage, this is for 132. These are the types of application as we have seen. And the rest are of about dielectric stress and single core. Now, let us start with the basic parts of, or we can say not basic, depth part of your cables. Okay, this is some kind of derivation written over here, but we will only see why it is for, and we will note it out some equation. Okay, so first we look for the single core, then we look for three core, because we have seen types of cable as single core and three core. Let us see. Single core means what? It consists of stranded copper conductor. Now you are able to find out the difference, as we have seen yesterday, you are able to find out the difference between solid, stranded and bundle conductor. I hope so. Stranded and bundle conductor. Okay, this is what we have covered in performance of transmission line. The types of conductor, that is stranded, solid and bundle conductor. So here we are using stranded copper conductor, a belt of insulation of impregnated paper and lead sheet over it. So this is nothing but a type of insulation. Okay, so as I have said, we are using certain types of insulation and lead sheet for our cable. So there are four types. One is belted, one is H type, one is SL and HCL. Okay. Yes. Now, suppose this is my one particular conductor. This is O or certain types of lead, and this is certain types of insulation. So these are the layers are being placed over the conductor. Okay. Now, as you know, the basic difference between conductor and cable. Here we are dealing with the single core cable. We are not dealing with the conductor. We are looking for cable. So you know what do you mean by cable? Cable is nothing but a combination of conductor and insulator. Okay, so insulation resistance of the single core cable is given as by this equation. Well, this is was somewhat derivation is, we will not look into this. So this we can note down this one. The resistance of insulation cable is given as rho upon 2 pi L ln R by capital R by small r. So we will just look for what is the notification is for. So L is nothing but length of that cable. Obviously, it is in meter. Length of cable. So where we look for the length. So this is my length. Then they are saying rho is there. Rho is the resistivity of insulator. Yes, it is there. So this is resistivity. Small r is the radius of single core. So this inside is nothing but a conductor. and these are from conductor to the final insulation. These are layers of insulation. Okay, as I say, conductor is surrounded by 7 layers. So if you go in detail of the cable insulation layer, so you will come to know there are 7 layers of insulation around the cable, and it belongs to the lead sheath, mechanical sheath, the insulation sheath, the net sheath. There are certain types of layer, and each layer is have some kind of functionality. Okay, definitely each layer is having some kind of use. Okay, but for this topic, there is no need of to go in detail of this layer. Maybe in next session we will come across it, the cable insulation topic, we will come across this layer part. Yes, so the final insulation resistance is given as rho. We know what is mean by rho, that is the resistivity of insulator. 2 pi is the given value, L is the length of that particular cable, R is the insulation internal sheath, radius of the internal sheath, and the small r is nothing but radius of the single core cable. Okay, this is the cable. Okay, now if you have just small difference, they are saying insulation resistance of cable is inversely proportional to its length. Yes, it is there, but if you, yes, R is inversely proportional to the insulation resistance of the cable. So R is nothing but insulation resistance, and it is inversely proportional to the length. So this is one kind of MCQ you might be asked in your GATE examination or competitive examination. I'll rub it for you because it's making somewhat itchy to eyes. Okay, so I'll say this is insulation resistance of cable, and next point is capacitance of single core cable. So the capacitance they have given as Q is equal to CV. So when we find out the basic potential difference between the conductor, you will come to know again the value of capacitance as, okay, so this is the basic formula, 2 pi epsilon ln capital D upon small d. Now these are the 2 points to be noted for insulation resistance for the single core cable. Okay, rest of the part is derivation, and as we have seen the performance of transmission line, where we have identified the mathematical equation for which one, resistance, inductance and capacitance. This is somewhat related to that one also, but here there is addition of insulation. Okay, in performance of transmission line, we have only deal with a conductor. Correct, if you remember, this is the basic difference between conductor and the cable. Okay, here the addition of insulation, and that's why, because of this insulation, there is slight change in equation of this resistance element, capacitive element and inductive element. Okay, so we have got 2 equation, and based on this we are will able to solve some numerical. That's why we are looking for this. So we have got resistive equation, we have got capacitive equation. Yes, now next point is to overcome the disadvantage of the cable. Why, what is the disadvantage of cable? Because of the stress distribution. If you go in detail of the insulation, then you will come to know the stress distribution is not uniform. Okay, so to have the uniform distribution of stress along the cable, we will look for the grading. So grading is the concept. This is most important for as per the grade point of view. The process of achieving uniform electrostatic stress in the dielectric of cable is known as grading of cable. Okay, so that is nothing but grading of cable. So this, in this process we will achieve uniform stress distribution in cable. That is nothing but grading of cable. Okay, so we are having 2 types. One is capacitance grading and another one is internal sheath grading. Okay, so we have 2 types. One is capacitance grading and another one is inter sheath grading. Now this in detail part is not much required. Only you need to know what you mean by grading and what are the formula for it. Okay, the rest of the part is this. This part is nothing but your theoretical one. Okay, no need to go on detail, because GATE examination is for the smart way of your study. This is not the how go in detail of it. This is the smart way. So the smart way for this is nothing but you should know the basic formula and basic depth knowledge of that particular things. Correct? Yes. Now we will look for the example of this equation. So capacitance grading, they are saying we will obtain a basic of uniform stress distribution. Means what? So for convenience I will explain this one. The process of achieving uniformity in the dielectric stress by using layer of different dielectric is known as capacitance grading. Means what? Suppose this is R1 is of some another material, this is of this another dielectric, this one is another dielectric, means the R1, R2, this is R3 and R4. So I'm trying to achieve the grading in terms of layers. Okay, this is first one, this is second one, this is third one. It goes on increasing as per my application demand. So each layer are having certain types of relative permittivity. Because we are moving. Yes, I know this topic is somewhat tricky, but it is important also. When you go in detail, we are moving for the inside of the insulation of the cable. Okay, so right now for this gate, you can only think in mind, it is only the way grading of cable is nothing but a way of achieving uniform stress distribution. That's it. If you just clear this one concept, we will come to know how we will achieve this uniform distribution. Okay, so for that we have achieved one formula which is known as Gmax is equal to Q upon 2 pi epsilon r. Okay, now this epsilon is nothing but your value of the relative permittivity. So you can observe here also epsilon 1 is greater than epsilon 2, epsilon greater than epsilon 3. So such type of grading you will observe in each case. As you move from the cable, your epsilon relative permittivity is gonna change. Okay, this is my cable conductor. So it's gonna change as we move by a distance. Okay, so they are saying with some methodology we will achieve grading of cable. In other methodology of cable, this is a second methodology. What they are saying, intersheath sheath grading. So intersheath sheath grading is nothing but we are, by distributing the stress uniformly, the breakdown of insulation can be avoided. Means what? What they are saying, suppose this is conductor and across this I am using a single insulation. Okay, if because of some mechanical damage or external factor, if this insulation grid break, so who is get harm? My conductor. So instead of this, I will use one grading mechanism. Means what? Over this conductor I have one layer of dielectric of another material. Here I am having another layer of dielectric. Here I am having another layer of dielectric. Means what? We are protecting. Aim is what? To protect our conductor. Okay. So that we are moving for intersheath grading. So because of this, we will definitely achieve a way of uniform stress distribution. And that's why this is another methodology that is known as intersheath grading. Okay, so here also we will have another equation of this grading is known as V1, that is nothing but your voltage between the conductor and intersheath, upon R. R is nothing but your radius of the conductor. This is suppose, yes, the figure is here itself. This is nothing but R. First we'll check one by one. This is R1. So after this conductor, I having the radius for the outer sheath, that is R1. I know this is somewhat tricky, but it is important also. R is the radius of outer sheath. So this is my last outer sheath, that is R. So what we have? We have the radius of the conductor. We have the radius of inside the conductor, inside insulation. We have the radius of outer insulation. And this goes on increasing. If I added another layer, another one R will come, and that is nothing but R3. So this goes on increasing. And what we are doing, we are protecting our or we are doing uniform stress distribution based on grading of the cable. Okay, so for gridding of the cable, we will have these two formula, that is G max, the gridding, maximum gridding is Q upon 2 pi epsilon R. This is one factor. This is one factor. And the second one is having G max is equal to V1 upon R into ln upon R1 plus R. So these R1 have the radius of that particular insulation, radius of that particular conductor. Clear? Yes. Now, what will the case in three core cable? Okay, as you know, these are the overhead line. As you know, these are the overhead line, and there might be chances of existing a capacitance between two current carrying conductor. Correct? Because this one will act as a one plate, this one is actually another plate, and there is a chances of capacitance. Same, now this is distance is very less. This is my sheath, insulation sheath. One conductor is there, this is another conductor is there, and this is another conductor. So there might be chances of existing of capacitance. Correct? Yes, why not? It should happen. So this is the existing of capacitance between the conductor. Also, we have seen there is a chances of existence of capacitance between your okay, if it is a fourth conductor, there is a chances of capacitance between the conductor and neutral. Okay, here also, this is my conductor and this will act as a one part. So I'll say there may be chances of capacitance in outer sheath or insulator and the conductor. So this is what nothing but there are the chances between the conductor and between the core and the sheath. Okay, clear. Now this is a very simple concept. So what they are saying, capacitance of three core cable. What we are looking for? We are looking for the capacitance of three core cable where you can say there is, this is much more important concept in overhead line because of nearer face conductor to one another to shield sheet. This is nothing but what we have looked for. So there may be chances of capacitance between core. So this is my one core and the sheath that is known as, that is given as CS. And there might be chances of capacitance existence between core to core, that is known as capacitance between core to core, which is known as CC. Correct? So this is the concept of capacitance. First, what we will look for? First, we look for the single core cable. We will look for the capacitance. So here the capacitance formula like this one. In three core, we have also looked for the capacitance. And here the formula is like this one. So you can just simply note down this formula. Derivation is not much important for this gate point of view. So capacitance per phase the conductor is nothing but what they have given, 3 by 2 into CY minus CX upon 6. Or you can see capacitors between the three phase conductor per phase of the conductor is CS, that is capacitance between of the sheath plus 3 times capacitance of the conductor, core to core. Okay, you can just note down it so that we will move further. Yes, I hope you are done. Yes. Yes. Before going to next topic, we will first solve one, at least one numerical based on this because time is very much less. Yes. So what they have here, what they have given? They have given what is the overall diameter of single core cable when it is working on three phase. Okay. I think some part is missing. How much kV it is? Yes, 264 kV. I think during this screenshot, I missed something. Okay. What is the overall diameter of the single core cable?
They are asking for the diameter of the single core cable of system 264 kV.
Maximum permissible stress in the dielectric is not 20 kV per meter, here again I miss, then answer will be what? Okay, so what they have given, okay, first let us see what we need to find out. What we need to find out, we need to find the overall diameter of the single core cable. So instead of diameter, we know in example, we always ask for the radius. Okay, we always ask for the radius. Diameter is never been asked. So first we will find out that the radius and we will multiply it by 2. We will get the final value of diameter. Okay. What they have given? They have given the rating of the system. They have given the dielectric maximum stress that can be handled. That is 20 kV per meter. And they have asked for diameter. Okay. Now we know
this is
RMS value of what they have given. Three-phase system. They have given the value for the three-phase system. This is nothing but RMS value. So we'll simply for three-phase system we'll convert by root 3. We'll get the value as 152.4 kV. And we need to find out its value for peak of phase voltage. Why peak of phase voltage? Because they have been asked for the damage of this particular insulation, or they are asking for maximum permissible stress that dielectric will not exceed. Okay, so we'll simply multiply it by root 2. We'll get the value of peak value per phase. Now you know the basic difference between the peak value and the average value. Okay, yes. So we have obtained the value of peak 1 and the G max is already given. So you know that we have calculated the value for G max. Now it is not needy because they have already given the value of G max. Maximum stress that dielectric can handle, that is known as G max. So it is 20 kilovolt per mm. Okay. Now there we have need to find out the value of diameter. So we simply put this value in our equation. Now equation is what? G max is equal to V by R into ln capital R by small r. Okay. Now this value Rn by RL, it is they are saying for economical size of cable, optimum ratio of sheath and core radii is given by R by R, and ln of E or natural log of E is nothing but 1. So we'll get the equation get modified as V by R. Okay, now I know this is much somewhat you will get confused, but if you have the practice on such type of example, you are able to solve this. Okay, in your curriculum, you are not such type of example, but if you know the basic formula, you are able to solve it because you have this calculator with you. You have to just put this value and you will get the final answer. Okay, now what we have? We have the G max, that is 20. We have the voltage, that is 215.5, and the R, which is need to find out. So simply we'll put the value of R. We will get it as 215 kV and this 20 kV. So kV kV get cancelled and we will have the unit as mm, that is 10.7 mm. Okay, now this what we have obtained, this is this one was the radius of the cable and they have been asked for diameter. So we'll simply multiply it with 2 and you will get the value of diameter. Okay, so this is what they have been asked in this example. Only we need to, yeah, I know this is, there is some part we have missed, that is nothing but this 264 kV. Okay, so only we have to put the values of for this G max, for this maximum permissible stress equation. So that is nothing but this. G max is equal to V upon R into ln R by R. If you know all remaining value, you are able to solve this example. Okay, yes. After that, these are just for your homework. I will, when I will post it, you will come to know, because we have less time. We'll complete our next part, that is distribution system. Okay, so we will have a look on this distribution system. Okay. This is another part of our system what we have looked for? We have looked for the overhead system, performance of parameter of overhead system. Then we have looked for underground system, underground cable. Now we are going to distribute this power with the help of certain parameter. Okay, so which parameter we need to consider in the distribution system that we look for in this example? So what they are saying, it is the part of the system in which electrical power is get distributed among various consumer. Okay, for their local use known as distribution. So we know the three aspects of our electrical system, that is generation. This midway is nothing but your transmission, and the last one is nothing but distribution. Okay, so in last session we have started with the SLD, that is from generation. We have looked for the transmission, your underground and your overhead transmission line. Now we have reached at the end of your power system topic, that is nothing but distribution system. Okay, so the question arises, which are the main functional part or functionality of this power system? So definitely we will have feeder pillar. Okay, so in last I have used this most of the time, we use this term feeder. Okay, so let us understood this in theoretical way, and I'll teach you in practical way. So yes, first one is feeder. So let us see what is mean by feeder. Feeder is nothing but one line or conductor which connects major station to the distributor, known as feeder. Okay, so if you just able to visualize this picture, so this is my substation. So this is my major station. Now to move this power, or to have the flow of this power from the substation to the one point to the distributor, I need one line for the distribution. So that is nothing but feeder. Okay, so we'll say from the center, from the, this distribution, main distribution, to this point, I'll need one kind of connecting line, that is called as distributor. So feeder is been connected to scenario of your, or you can say two parts, that is nothing but your main substation and your distributor. That is nothing but, so feeder is nothing but a simply we'll say conductor. We are connecting the main substation and distributor by one conductor, and that is known as feeder. Now obviously this feeder is of some high size, high rating. Why? Because we are connecting that particular substation to the distributor. So definitely this line or conductor, it is called as feeder. Okay, yeah. So now we have arrived at the distributor. So what do you mean by distributor? Distributor is also a line or conductor to which various consumers are connected through service main, that is called as a distributor. Okay, so distributor is another concept where large consumer, medium consumer, industrial sector, commercial sector, domestic sector are being connected as per their power demand, that is known as distributor. Okay, so a line or conductor to which various consumers are connected through service mains.
So this also important aspect, they will ask for one mark, that is
distributor is the one where a line being connected to the consumer through service main. In feeder, we have connected our main substation to the distributor. In distributor, we connect to the consumer through service main. So these are interlinked concept. So what do you mean by service main? Service main is a line or cable or conductor which connects consumer to the distributor, that is known as service main. Because a distributor is connected through service main. So you can observe here, this is service main. Here we can connected our consumer. Okay, so where we started? Where we started with the feeder, then we reach at the distributor. So this is one kind of flow of electric power in our power system in distribution aspect. Correct? So we started with the substation, we connected to distributor by the feeder, distributor get connected with the consumer by the serviceman, and serviceman is the one where our consumers are get connected. Next, classification of this distribution system. So we can classify based on the DC, we can classify based on the AC. Construction, we can distribute the power overhead way, and we can distribute the power in underground system. correct? According to the service, we can utilize this for lighting purpose or feeding the power. We can utilize this for industrial sector. We can utilize it for government sector, railways, and we can use for street light. So there are, these are not limited. These are number of service are there. Okay. These are the number of service we can use for the distributor. Now, the question is how many wires being used for the distribution? So we can use 2-wire system. We can use 3-wire system. We can use 4-wire. Why I'm using word wire? Because distribution can be in both way, overhead and underground. Okay, that's why I'm using term wire. Now the situation is in how or in which way we can connect this system of distribution. So we will have a radial system, we will be having ring system, and we will be having interconnected system. Correct? So these are the ways or these are the classification of distribution system where we are connecting our distribution scenario with our consumer. Okay, so the point for the remember is distribution are having DC as well as AC. We will distribute the power in overhead and underground. We will use all the types of services. We will use for this scheme of connection is radial way, ring type, and interconnected system. Okay, so which is the best one? Interconnected is the best one, because one get failure, other will share that particular load. And why we are, I'm using term load, because this is what interconnected system means. One system get fail, you can utilize your load, you can run your appliances on the basis of sharing phenomena. So that is happens in interconnected system. Okay. Yes. Now next is DC distribution and AC distribution. So we'll just in short time we'll see what is DC and AC. So the electric power is almost exclusively generated, transmitted, distributed as AC. Okay. What we have seen? We have seen the SLD where we have generated, transmitted, and distributed power as AC. But there are certain applications, which will run on DC supply. Likewise, your special machine, DC motors, some drives. So these are DC is absolutely necessary because we cannot operate beyond that. Okay. So for this purpose, we will convert AC into DC at the substation level, and this DC power get distributed in terms of 2-wire system and 3-wire system. Okay. In AC distribution, definitely when we start with the AC, there is one term arises, transformer. Correct? So for AC distribution, we will having some transformer. And for DC distribution, we will be having inverter. Inverter converter phenomena. Okay. This is the major role of this is not major role, this is a devices or equipment being used for this distribution. Okay, and all this happen at the substation level. Clear? Yes. So let us have a look on this AC distribution. So what this says, AC distribution is the electrical power or energy is variably generated, transmitted, distributed in the terms of AC. Yes, we know that. The main reason of adopting the AC system for the generation is that AC voltage can be conveniently be changed to desired, yes, to the help of, this is most important, with the help of transformer. So what we have seen in AC, when we are dealing with AC distribution, definitely we will be having transformer. Now there are certain types of transformer being used for the distribution. Okay, load distribution transformer, power transformer is there. As per the demand, the rating on a change. Okay, so these are the distribution type, AC distribution and DC distribution. Okay. So, yes. Now let us see, what do you mean by radial? What do you mean by ring and interconnected distribution? Okay. So what they are saying, primary distribution and secondary distribution part that we have seen in SLD. Okay, so let us go in detail, in depth part, we'll see the system in which electrical power is conveyed from 11 kV or 66 kV or 3.3 kV to different substation for distribution or for the particular consumer. So that consumer will be industry, factory, is called as a primary distribution. Yes, we know that. But for the secondary distribution, here we are connected our domestic and the commercial system, where we get the power from 11 kV that we have generated to 400 volt and 230 volt. Okay, this is a large part is being involved in this. That is, various consumer are operating on low voltage. Now, this is a belongs to the low voltage, and we will call it as secondary distribution system. Okay, so if the question might ask in exam that the about the power distribution in a distribution in primary and secondary distribution system, so basic difference in secondary, we are connected with the low voltage distribution scenario, correct? And now we are saying the distribution, suppose this is at my distribution substation, and from this I have to distribute power to each consumer. Okay, there are plenty of consumers. Suppose I'm saying one kind of city, and there is population is about 50 lakh. So it is my responsibility to get each consumer will get electricity easily, promptly, and for all duration of time. So this distribution plays an important role. So here there are certain ways we can connect our all the consumer to the my substation, distribution substation. Okay, that is nothing but a radial way, a ring way, and interconnected way. So in radial system, separate feeders are utilized for the single substation, and that is being fed to the distributor at one end only. Okay, so this is called as radial. We are feeding the power from one end only. Okay, this is most important. We are feeding the power from only one end. What do you mean by ring system? Here we are using two feeder in parallel. So if one get failure, we will have switch on the another route. Means if this get failure, so this power consumer connected to at this end will get affected. So I will just switch. I will switch this load on this another feeder. Okay. So if we are in ring system, we are having parallel feeder. But in interconnected system, what will happen?
We are having two or more than two generating station are being connected, and all are connected in the system of ring feeder. So ring feeder means what? If one get affected or two get affected, remaining system will try to supply the power to the consumer. Okay, these are nothing but the ways of connection to the consumer with the help of distribution system. Okay.
Yes. So okay, we'll skip this part because we are not have that much time, and let us. Pole mounted, okay. Yes, we'll see the substation part. Okay, because we have limited time, we will see this substation part. What this does it mean? So substation, what we have seen right now, we have seen the classification based on distribution. So substation are nothing but these are located from generating station to the consumer premises. Definitely that is nothing but a role of substation. So classification of substation by the nature of duty, definitely we have seen primary substation, we have seen the secondary substation. So primary is definite, basically is a step up substation, or we can say primary substation. In such type of substation, we will generate low voltage like 3.3, 6.6, 11 or 33 kV. And that is being step up with the help of step up transformer for transmitting the power to the large distance. Okay. And definitely your primary substation are located near the generating station. As we have generated our power at 11 kV, now that being get transmitted with the help of substation, primary substation with the help of 230, 440. So these are the rated we have guessed transmitted. Now next is step down. Okay, apart from the we will have primary grid also, but that is not that much concern. Step down, we will use a step down transformer where we have to utilize the power for secondary distribution. So secondary distribution we will use, definitely we will use step down transformer. Okay, now this transformer or the substation are categorized as outdoor, indoor, underground and pole mounted substation. Indoor means what? We can use up to 11 kV. Okay, I'm highlighting key points of this substation. You can have a look later. Outdoor substation, we can use up to 66 kV. So this is the basic difference. In indoor, we can utilize, we can use up to 11 kV, but in outdoor substation, we can use up to 66 kV. For underground also, it is used in high populated area where space of the equipment and building is limited. So, and at that kind, we will use for underground. Pole mounted is definitely, we have observed such pole mounted transformer. We have observed in our day-to-day life, we have observed such type of pole mounted transformer. Each pole is there, each frame is there, and we have seen certain transformer have been installed. This is called as H pole mounted transformer. This is a regular or day-to-day example of transformer. And now from this pole mounted transformer, the substation, we will move for the transformer. Okay, so there are certain types of transformer, there are certain types of ways to connect it through this system. That is nothing but your way of connection. Okay, so I think this is enough for today's session, and that is the end of power line, power system session for the gate. So what we have looked for, this was the last one, was one limited version. I know that one, but based on that we will look for different scenario of power system. We have looked for performance parameter of this power system. We have looked for different line parameter calculation. So we have seen resistance, inductance, capacitance, their equation for this line parameter calculation. As you know, we have seen this basic among all the scenario. This is the most important factors that we have seen so far. That is this one. Yes, performance of all the parameter. Okay, so if you know this one thing, so I hope you will able to understand each and every parameter, because here we have noted out all the things of resistance, inductance, inductive reactance, capacitance, capacitive reactance. So what it tells? It tells how my parameter will perform, how will my parameter will operate when there is a change in something. So something is what, if there is a change in length, if there is a change in distance, if the radius is going to change, if there is a symmetrical spacing, unsymmetrical spacing. So all the factors will affect on the power system. In one table, we have noted out all this scenario. Okay, so from my side, this is a most important parameter of this power system. So what we have seen in these two sessions, we have seen the performance of transmission line, line parameter and the corona. Also, we have seen distribution system. Then we have seen the cables and the types of the distribution transformer. Okay, so this is for this particular session, as we have looked for all the aspect of the power system scenario. In next, I think one session is remaining. So let us see which point we will cover. Definitely, I think we will go for the economic power generation and load dispatch center, because that is another most important point for this power system. So in this overall scenario, also we look for a solve gate example, which will definitely helpful for all of you. So the scenario is what? Just once again, let me stop my recording first. So this was the two power system session, that what we are look for this in this particular gate session, which is arranged by Prerna Center.